and gentlemen, get ready for the big cutscene. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, so, in this episode, we will be taking on Hyrule Castle, and we will be working towards getting to the final boss. I'm pretty sure that I'm going to do the final boss on a part 2 episode, because this is going to take a little while, and I don't think the boss fight and all the cutscenes and stuff will get done in all one episode, plus this. So, we're going to take it as quickly as we can to get to the big attraction, but just look how gorgeous those graphics are and everything that's going on. It's really, really cool. A little reminiscent of Ocarina of Time. Okay, so in this courtyard, we have lots and lots of enemies, and we have a feature that we haven't really seen too much of before, but we're going to have a lot of from this point. But it's easy. I wouldn't even remember shooting, it's just simple. So, there's that. We're gonna have a lot of those barriers that are gonna be very highly based on kill all the enemies and then proceed. We are gonna be utilizing a lot of our tools because this is kind of the wrap up to the game and they want you to have to use every tool to make you appreciate that you went out of your way to go and get them. Speaking of things that we went out of our way to go and get, how cool are those few shadows when Midna finally got to use her ancestor's power and take out that barrier? That's really cool. That's really cool. Yard, there shouldn't be too much to do. There are some hidden secrets and stuff, nothing too major. We're going to be taking on the left side, then the right side, and then heading through the main gate. We need a couple of keys to get through, so that is what we are trying to accomplish. I'm really glad they have rain going for the graphics because I feel like it sets up. Killed him enough times.
Yeah.
three hearts. All you really have to do is just his weapon requires him to be very slow in order to use it. Honestly, I don't imagine this thing. I haven't actually seen him do that before. I know, how impressive. After all that time, he actually said something. We are going to be trying to keep our hearts up as much as possible, so if I'm low, I'm going to be trying to break everything to get our hearts up again, because I want the Great Spin Strike to be able to do as much massive damage as possible. So, I believe we've done everything in this area that we can do. I don't think there's anything special or hidden or anything like that. Now, to my knowledge, that's the last we ever see of that guy. And we have basically completed everything we needed to do. There was probably a way up on the other side of the wall or something. I don't know. It's a basic little chest. I'm sure it just had a few rupees in it. I'm not honestly that concerned about it. One side down, one more to go. I'm gonna try to avoid the front gate because I think it slams down another barrier. And then I have to kill a bunch of shit, and we might as well do that when we go back through. Seems not quite as tough without that extra damage on it. Side up. In this area, there's going to be a lot of stupid archers. I will actually not be taking out every single one of these fucking things, because frankly, they're annoying. Come on. I did that on purpose. I didn't mean to dash the first time. So here we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is that enough? It's not enough. Okay. It's a little bit of a puzzle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can't remember if there's a proper pattern, so I would say the best way to go about doing this is actually 1, and it should hit that one automatically, 2, there. Let's try that. Is that enough? That was not enough. Jesus! I can't remember if there's a proper combination or not. Isn't that right? That looked right to me. Let's try the other direction. We'll try at the tip of the Triforce. We go left, right, mid. Maybe I just wasn't hitting them correctly or something. I have no idea. So this should be key number 2, or is this this is the map probably. This is the dungeon map. Okay, shit. I thought there was a key. Maybe it's up here. Good. I don't think there was. Was there a key? I can't remember. I thought we needed 2 keys. I don't think there was one hidden in the area. Is this a key? This is a stamp. That's fantastic. I have no idea where the other key is. Well, shit, that doesn't look good at all. Let's try something really quick. Still might be a key. I don't see any torches to light. Sorry, Piggy. I really could have sworn there was an extra key somewhere. Well, I give up. Fuck it. If I have to, I will come back and get something. But I could have sworn there was a second key there. Well, we got this key taken care of at least. And it's fine. Okay, so in here we have a room with a ridiculous number of chandeliers. I have no idea why. I think there's a hidden key, and you use it to find a hidden treasure room right before. So, unfortunately, we probably won't be hitting that if I don't have the second key. I could have sworn. Because I know it has like a stamp, a bunch of rupees, some basic supplies. I did actually mount up a bunch of the supplies that I had at the time. So, I don't really need it, and I guess if I come back and do the stamps, it would probably be worth my time to actually research and do, but nobody's actually probably caring that much about that room. So, there's a lot of treasure chests in this room. This is the compass. There's also a shit ton of doors. This is, if we're counting this as a dungeon, this is the most amount of fucking doors we've had in one central location. I mean, just look at that game. Now, the way this room works is kind of similar to the outside. We need to get through the main door, but we're going to need some stuff to do that. We're going to go on the left side and then the right side of all of this crap like we did before. Ready to go, buddy? These guys are just so weak. Damn, backwards was probably not the best idea. Oh, come on, I back dodged that. Hit me. Hit me again. That's the easiest to deal with. Okay, so in this room, I believe we need to use the lantern to light stuff up like we did in the first dungeon, where we had to bring the pedestal up. So I'm gonna guess here and here. There's one. There's two. Okay, now this is a little ass backwards, but it's actually turning it out, isn't it? So, we got plenty of lantern oil. I'm not even remotely worried about it. Don't think there's anything hidden here. And I don't think the rest of the floor... Does the rest of the floor come off? What the fuck, bro? Oh, it's a trick. So we got some rupees for our troubles. Meh. Let's see. There are two paths. I'm gonna take this path. Because like I said, we want to go left and then right. Took about 3,000 rupees, so that magic armor is going to be very, very powered up for the boss fight. I think I'm going to use it from start to finish. I really think I will. Okay. Easy enemies. Damn it, they got the head off. Come on, come here. A head full of hearts, and they didn't get that freebie off on me. I would have been able to knock them out in one hit. Sucks. Oh well. So, not that you would fucking know this, but you have to shoot the painting. You have to release that so that you can get a swing off at that. Bastards. Wait a second. Was that the right portrait? If you get the wrong one, you get chewed. What is that bullshit? Okay, so that one wasn't it. That one wasn't it. Is it this one or the first one? Thank you. So, note for next time, don't waste your time with the other two pictures. You have to hit this specific picture. This time, two nights. I dealt with this in the Cave of Ordeals. That's going to be a bonus episode for after we've actually completed this. You end up having to take on, like, three of them at the same time. Honestly, they're really not that hard. Your best strategy, though, is just to milk out one of them. By doing that. Then you go back a little bit, and you have him come over. Now, it's really not that hard taking them both out at the same time, but this is just easier. So, same strategy as before. Not quite that. Throws. We're one hit short on this asshole. Kind of surprised, they usually have a charge attack to move the distance before you. Super easy. You know, the one thing I don't get about these guys, though, is they look like, even though I know they're like bad guys underneath, Temple of Time is where we found these guys in the first place, and they're all over Hyrule Castle. These seem like to be good knights. Like, if you're actually watching in, like, Super Smash Brothers, Smash 4, one of Zelda's attacks is summoning one of these guys, so I actually think that they're good, and I have no idea why they're attacking. If it's a demon possession thing, if it's a confusion and they think we're the bad guys or something. Fuck you and your three-hit combo. Hit me. No, I said miss me. No. Yeah. So that opened the two doors. We actually want, I believe, this door. I believe. Wrong door. We'll come back to that door, but wrong door. We want the other door. So if we come in here, we can get to a treasure chest. Which this is, again, the main room that we were just in a second ago. So we get this chest, which I think is probably 50 rupees. Pretty typical. And then we hit this switch for another chest over there that we can't get to. Probably be coming back to actually, you know what? I think we can get this one. If we jump down, which you might think is a bad idea, but we should be able to get back up. Maybe, hopefully. Come on, pretty please. If not, I'll probably have to run the whole distance all over again, but it shouldn't be that bad because the way is open. I think I just screwed myself. Look at that. Silver rupee 200. Not bad. I think I might have fucked up. So I'm pretty sure there aren't any close range chandeliers that I can get to. Nope. I screwed the booch. So, we'll jump back down and I'll run back there very, very quickly. Probably should have waited later, but I'm pretty sure we alter the chandelier so that we can come and go easier after we get everything done. But anyway, we're gonna run around. With this video was a little bit different than any other video. Most of the time, I actually do everything on camera. I try not to cut anything out, and I ended up basically running around and getting everything so that we would have enough time to get this dungeon done with plenty of extra time in case we got there, like, really quickly, and I wanted to take off on the final boss in one big episode, but I don't think that's what's gonna end up happening, so... Even if we're being quick, it's probably still going to be a good 45-minute dungeon. We're about 27 minutes in. I don't think there's a mini-boss. I think it's just filled with very strong enemies constantly, so it's kind of evened out a little bit. Plus, it's not really a dungeon, even though you get a dungeon map. I mean, it's Hyrule Castle, for God's sakes. So, we probably need to go up there. Do we? I don't think we do. Hold on. Let's go this way first. Bosky. Yeah, we need to come here first. Look at all of them. Look at all of them! Oh my god! I can still take them all out. I doubt they have that good of a range, even if they are up high. Look at that slick shit. That one little hawk did all that. Oh my lord. So we've got our boss key, so we're ready to go. Not that I actually need it anymore. So we're gonna come back in this direction. There's a chest on the opposite side. I bet it's a stand. I don't know if we can access it from this side, though. We might have to go all the way around. Actually, I don't even think it really mattered, to be honest. We're gonna have to duke this one out, though. We won't have anybody to rescue our asses. Oh, it's a reprint. Okay, so we had this guy in a previous dungeon. He was a sub-boss, and then they have a habit of, like, doubling him up as, like, just... I don't know. They really aren't that difficult, like, at all. They're a very basic strategy. You want to keep a little bit of distance, but not too much distance. You want to keep the right angle because otherwise you're going to miss your shot when you try to pull him down. If you get the right combo, you can just execute him in one fell swoop, so that wasn't even remotely be intimidating. Yay, we got a small key. Maybe that's the key we need. I hope so. We can't get in through that door, which tells me that there's something important on the other side, which means we'll have to come back in, and we can probably go in through this door. I guess we'll have to. I thought we were going to use that key for something else, but whatever. So we come in, and what do we got? Oh, is this morbid-ass weird shit. So, check this out. This is where I feel like it gets really morbid. Shit. Fucking mice, dude. We're literally watching the ghosts point in which direction is safe to cross. You don't even have to wait for them to point. If you just see which way they're facing, it'll dictate to you which is the safe pattern you're actually supposed to take. To me, it's still a little bit morbid, though. I don't know if I can make that. Oh god. I tried to slow down and it didn't slow down quick enough. Alright. We can hookshot that part, but honestly, what's the point if you can just do that? And because we have the great slice. So with this one, you can't just hop the gap. You actually have to use your double hookshot, which is kind of neat. Big of a deal. I will go back and finish those parts in the cleanup episode for the postals. If anybody watches this, and if anybody wants me to do the postals and stamps and all that, it'll require me to go back that direction. So, one more of these fuckers. Why, I don't know. They're not really that difficult. Attack them. Oh, that didn't work. When you guys are ready, come join me in the next episode, because we're going to take out the big boss, and we're going to be done with the game finally. I'm so excited. Peace.